All right, I've got enough metal to actually make 3 molds. What I've done though is I've only cut enough metal to make 2. If everything works out right with these two, I'll go ahead and cut this last remaining piece of metal so I can have 2 more blanks. Hopefully our cutter will last long enough to do that. Something I had to do is think about, did I want a mold with a sprue plate or a mold with a V on it? Now obviously with the sprue plate, the cavity is going to sit right here, and then you know how a sprue plate works. Once I hit it, it'll cut it off and I'll have a little flat spot there, and then the ball will drop out. If I just have a hole in the coming down to the center with a V notch cut into it, say right here, I'll be able to drop the balls, and then each time I'll have to take a pair of snips, snip it off, take the scrap lead, drop it back. It'll be a little more time consuming. I think it'll look more professional if we have a sprue plate. I don't think it's going to really affect anything else on our mold. If you were to take a look at these two blocks here sitting side by side, imagine them clamped together with our mold handles. Imagine this is the hidden line inside the blocks. That's our gonna, imagine that as the cavity for our little cannonball. We've got plenty of material in the corners to drill a hole for our sprue plate. I mean, we've got plenty of meat in there, so I don't think that's going to be an issue. All right, now we'll go ahead and take our pieces of metal over to the milling machine. We'll clamp them in a vise and I'll face them off. That way our faces where our cavity is going to be are completely flush and completely smooth for our mold here. All right, let's go ahead and take these, put these in the mill vise, and we'll face those on. We've got all 4 blocks faced off. I'm going to go ahead and mark on these blocks where I want to start my hole. All right. Now, let me use a quarter as an example. We want to put the hole about right here. What I'll do is I'll measure down the same amount from the top of each block where the top of the mold is going to be. We know our ball is going to be 1.092 inches in diameter, 1.090, which is the actual cutter diameter I wound up with. So what I'll do is I'll measure down about 600 thousandths of an inch. All right. What that'll do is give me the ability to face off the top of the mold blocks down to the mold cavity. And we'll do that to both blocks. Measure down 600 thousandths of an inch, and it's real easy to mark it. All right, 0. All right, we'll mark our caliper. Let's see. You got to make sure you have the right angle on it, or you're going to get a false reading. All right, right there. Make sure you're marking from the top. Okay, right here. And I'll do the same for these two. 600 thousandths of an inch. That's where the hole's going to be. The center of the hole. Now, that'll give us 50 thousandths between the top of our cavity and the top of our block. So all I should have to mill off is 50 thousandths of an inch. Now each block, I didn't mill the sides, so each block is going to be slightly different in width. So what I've got to do is take each block individually and find center. Now for this first block, we are exactly 2 inches and 13 thousandths wide. Well, 2 and 16, yeah, 2 and 13. All right, that equates to 1 inch, 1.00, we can go 1/7 or 1/6 to make it easy. All right, 1.006 and a half. Well, 0.6. All right, now, if I do the same thing I did before, make a mark like here, like I did, you can't really see this particular mark as well. Let me do something to make it easier for you to see it. I think you can see that pretty good. Now right there is where our center of our hole is going to be for this particular block. I'll mark each of the remaining three blocks the same way, and when I put them in the mill vise, I'll show you exactly how we're going to center them. What we're going to do first though is when I drill these things, I'm going to start out with a 3/4 inch ball end mill. I'll go down into the block about 0.05 of an inch in depth. Remember, we want to go 5/46 for our finish depth. What this ball end mill will do is remove, it'll hog out a lot of the extra material that might be difficult for our homemade cutter to remove. That way it has less work to do. So we'll use this 3/4 inch ball end mill first, take it down to 540 or about 0.05 of an inch in depth, and then we'll go ahead and swap out cutters. We'll put in our homemade cutter and we'll go back to 546 thousandths, and we'll do the same thing with all four blocks. Alright guys, we've got our 1/2 of our mold block clamped in a mill vise. In case you're wondering, I don't plan on getting these things so perfect that I could clamp them together and that the each half of the hole is going to be perfectly aligned. What I'm going to do later on is make an alignment ball. I'll make one out of aluminum. I'll set it in each, half this half of the mold, take the other mold, set it over top, it'll align the cavity, and then I'll clamp it and I'll drill it for our alignment pins. Doing that will make it easier, I think, for as far as just running straight forward and getting this hole set up to drill. And what we're going to do to keep this end mill centered up perfectly on the mark we made is a little trick a machinist at work taught me. You put a piece of putty on the end of your end mill, and on that you put a needle. What you'll do then is you turn on your milling machine and you touch the needle until it's perfectly centered. I'll show you what I mean. See that right there? Now, the tip of that needle is perfectly centered. It is on this turning exactly on the center of the axis of this 3/4 inch end mill. And I'll adjust my table in and out, left and right, until we're dead on the mark that we scribed on our mold block. And that I'll put our end mill dead center on the mark. All right. And we'll do the same thing with all four blocks, and that'll get us where we need with that. All right, now that we've got that centered, what we're going to do is I'm going to turn on the milling machine, run the end mill down just till we touch the surface of our block. All right, then I'm going to set the digital readout on my quill, and we're going to go down 500 thousandths of an inch. We want a total depth of 546, so we'll go down 500, maybe a little bit less, and we'll finish it off with our custom-made cutter. Okay, right there we went exactly half of an inch. We'll use our custom cutter to finish the hole. This is a 3/4 inch end mill we're using. It's a round end mill. Our hole, of course, is going to be 1 inch. And what we've done, as I stated earlier, is we've got less metal to hog out. Right there, we're touching our mold block. It's zeroed. I left a small mark on it. Okay, our mill table is now zeroed again. Put some cutting fluid in here. Fill that hole up. Now we will see how well our cutter works. I do not know how well this is going to work. I hope it works out good for us. Alright, it's not cutting real easy. Alright. I'm going to have to quit right now and see what we can do about modifying the cutting edge on our cutter. Because it's not cutting as easily as I hoped it would. So I'm going to take a look at that. And then perhaps relieve it more on the back side. I'll get my sanding disc out, relieve it more on the back side, and we'll start over. Alright, what I've done is I've relieved the back edge of this more and basically try to give this more of a sharper edge. It's still not a real sharp edge. Hopefully it will work for us this time. We're going to go ahead and try it again. It's working a little bit better this time. We're 1/4 inch deep. Alright, we're 300 thousandths of an inch deep. Hopefully the chatter marks will be gone when our cavity is finished. I'll go just a couple thousandths at a time and hopefully it'll wear itself in. We can also try to polish that out later on. It is working. thrilled we're getting so much use out of our cutter. It's really working great. I am really thrilled with how it came out. All right, that's 546 thousandths right there. All right, here's our mold halves. Each one came out perfectly, as close as I need it. This is the first set we made, this is the second set, and this is the third set. Our cutter worked great. It did not wear down, it did not get to the point that I had to even try to resharpen it. It did leave a small lip of material here on our mold block, and I think the reason for that is, as it cut down and it pushed that metal out, if you look closely, I don't know if you'll be able to see it or not here under the camera, but there is a spot where when I dished this out with the 3/8 inch ball end mill, I did not come close to the edge over here, and I think that left a dull spot, which is why on these blocks it kind of left a little bit of ridge of metal around the hole as it finished the hole. That's no big deal. What I'll do is I'll take this razor scraper, it holds a old-fashioned type flat razor blade in it. I'll scrape around those the circumference of these holes, clean that ridge off, and then we'll start turning our alignment ball we're going to use to align our halves. Alright, here's our aluminum bar stock. It's 1¼ inches in diameter. This is the same raw stock. I made the reloadable cases for my 26.5mm flare launcher. It's a 6061 T6. What we're going to do is simply, since our ball, our sphere needs to be 1.092 inches in diameter, we'll just simply come out about, well, let's go 1 200,000ths. We'll make a mark. We'll cut it right here. This is all we need for our stock. We'll cut it, put it in the lathe. We'll face off each end. Maybe I'll cut it a little bit longer, but we'll face off each end, and then I'll drill it about 3/4 inch through and tap it the diameter needed for the size needed for our mandrel here. This is going to hold our stock in the chuck. We've got a steel, our mandrel here is a steel rod, it's 1/2 inch in diameter. Our threads on the end are a 3/8 diameter, it's a 3/8 by 16 national coarse thread. But this will hold our stock while we turn our sphere. Alright, we'll go ahead and I'll go ahead and get this cut off. We'll switch over to the lathe and we'll pick up there. Alright, before we get our ball turning tool post out and mount it on here, our ball turning attachment, I got to take and turn the outside diameter of our workpiece to the diameter of the sphere we need, or very, very close to it. I'm going to take it to 1.0, and maybe just one, since our sphere is 1.092, I take this down to 1.1, 1.125. That way it'll give us plenty of material to work with our ball turning attachment, and we won't have to take too much material off. So we'll get this cut down and then we'll change tool posts. Let's run this in a little bit closer to where there's less deflection. All right, now that we've got it turned down, it's 1.110 or 20 thousandths of an inch or so larger in diameter than what we our final diameter is going to be, which is fine. We'll go ahead and leave it right there. Take our cutter out. Now we'll change out our tool post and put our ball turning attachment on our lathe here. All right, we've got our cutter, and I've adjusted it so it's approximately towards the, not the center of the workpiece, but a little bit closer to this outer edge up here. Now I've got to turn it away from it so that as I rotate the cutter past this edge right here, I can get just the tip past it. We'll go in just a little bit more until it's ready to contact that. And then we'll start turning our sphere. I'll probably have to move it back to bring this radius up as well. Well, you'll see what I mean when I actually start doing it. Sometimes it's easier to show you than explain. I'm just trying to be careful here. What I'm doing right now is I'm moving the whole sphere turning attachment in towards the headstock a little bit at a time as I turn this radius right here. .094. I had a little bit of tool chatter on it, so we have some marks on here, but that's all right. We'll go ahead and sand that out. We're 2/1000ths of an inch larger than we actually want, so it won't be a big deal. Smooth that out a little bit. All right, since we're at 1.090, we'll take our mandrel out of the chuck, turn around, put the ball in, clamp it down, and we'll just face off the end right here, this little bit of aluminum that's sticking out. I think the best way to do this and try to save as much of the profile as we can is to use a sanding disc on my 90 grinder. I think that's good enough. Now, let's see how it fits on our mold halves. All right, our alignment ball is not fitting in our mold blocks perfectly. It's not going in as far as I thought it would. I know our cutter was 1.090 inches in diameter. And it looks like our hole right here is 1.030. So for some reason, I don't know if it was tool deflection or what, our hole is actually about 60 thousandths of an inch undersized or so. Yeah, maybe 1.037. Make our alignment ball a little bit smaller so it fits in our mold blocks. Make it 1.030. I can't believe that we're off by that much. I mean, our radius right here 1.094. I don't understand it. Anyway, it's not that big a deal. The cannon that we're making this for will still be able to shoot the ball. It's better to have it a little bit smaller than too large for the bore. All right, let's go ahead and fix this. We'll make it a little bit smaller by doing just what I was doing before, and we'll double check it with our mold blocks. Now, this is going to work out all right. For some reason, the ball doesn't fit in our cavity perfectly. It seems like it's a little bit longer maybe than what it should be. I can't figure out exactly what's going on with it. What we're going to do is I'm going to put a couple pieces of tape in between these two mold blocks right here. That way it'll stop the wiggle around the ball that I've got. And we'll put that tape on there, clamp them together, and then we'll drill this block right here for alignment pins and get ready to put those in. What I'm going to do here is put some tape between the two halves, and that'll keep them from wobbling. And I'm also going to put a piece of tape around the ball itself to make it fit tighter in our cavity. I'm just going to start at the top, go all the way around. We're going to clamp those two together. Clamp them together, drill it for alignment pins, and then we'll go ahead and press the alignment pins in one side, and that'll be this mold block. After that, we'll put it in the mill vise. We'll mill off the sides and the top true to each other, and the bottom as well.